All right, here we are for round one on the draw. I think this is the lower end of hands that I'm willing to keep. Fairy Mechanist Otherworldly Journey is a nice little synergy, and we have a Land Cycler to help fix our red splash. Or if we draw a double blue card. All right, looks like we might be getting punished if our opponent has some quick creatures. This is a good draw, though. Helps us stave off some early aggression, at least. So it looks like our opponent is an affinity deck as well. Hopefully we can outvalue him with these things. They seem pretty good. If he misses a land drop here, that would be really bad for him. Okay, so I'll probably Pyrite Spellbomb his guy during his upkeep, maybe? There's no reason to do it during his upkeep, I suppose. I can do it after he attacks. No, I should do it during his upkeep. He might have that white combat trick that I am blanking on the name of at the moment. I think I'd rather kill his guy than play a Kitchen Finx at the moment. Okay, he's just going to draw a card. Yeah, I'll just kill this guy now. Then we can Sanctum Gargoyle back our Spell Bomb. Seems good. Ooh, Ravager. That's a good one. I'm just going to regrow our Spell Bomb and pass. Cool new art for the Ravager. Definitely gonna block if he attacks. Looks like he's missing a land also, so he's just gonna do nothing. Alright, I'm gonna play Pyrite Spellbomb. I think we should just Spellbomb his guy during his upkeep and then Pestermite his land. We can take a Journey also to regrow our Spellbomb again if we need to. Could put a counter here. Ah, he chose not to. That's probably wise. I like just pestermining his land to stay aggressive. Amaru Seekers, sure. So I think I'm going to lead off with the Fairy Mechanist and see where that gets us. Because we have Bone Splitter in our deck and stuff that we could draw. Okay, well, it gets us nowhere. So we will just hit for four. Trying to decide if I want an Otherworldly Journey now or just save it. I think saving it's probably fine. I'm not gonna block this even if he Bone Splitters it, because we can block with Kitchen Finks later. Ah, he has a Cloud Goat Ranger of his very own. That's pretty good. Alright, now I think I'm gonna Otherworldly Journey and regrow our Spell Bomb. We had to do that in his second main phase so that we could successfully regrow. Alright, gonna lead off with the Mechanist. Whiff again. Boy, these have not been the best Mechanists of all time. So, I'll just attack with the Sanctum Gargoyle, because he can jump and we double block. He can jump and block and it trades. And that would be fine. looks like that's what he's going for. I'm okay with that. Leaves us with 6 flying power and a pyrite spell bomb to his not very much. And we also have a Finks, although he does have 4 spells in hand, probably. Sure. So we'll just take it, I think. Go to 10. And then Finks will gain us some life. Gross. That's pretty annoying. Regrows, Arcbound Stinger. Okay. I think we should just attack with everybody and trade the spell bomb. As unfortunate as that is, we sort of 2-for-1 ourselves here. But I think it's the correct thing for us to do in this case, because it gives us such aerial superiority. I still like our spot reasonably well. I would have just preferred if we'd hit with either of these mechanists. Alright, he has a mechanist of his own that also whiffed. The two of us have some nice mechanists. Tagging with just the Kithkin. I think I can take 3, that's fine. And probably moving Bone Splitter to a soldier. Alright, that's good. Can kill off his guy and attack with all the flyers again. I'm trying to decide if we should just swing out. We don't die on the crackback unless he has a way to pump another bone splitter. He probably blocks this on this and maybe this there. Yeah, it doesn't seem that good. Just attack with these two, I think. It's fine. This turn, I probably will block the bone-splittered guy with Kitchen Finks, though. Our life total is getting low enough that it might be something to watch out for. Alright, send in the clown, sir. Yeah, I'll just block. Stinger and Worker, and then he can trade off. Oh, he didn't equip. Ugh, that must mean he has, like, the Test of Faith or whatever. Or he just missed it. Well, it seems likely that he has Test of Faith, and we will lose if that happens to us. So, that makes me want to not attack. Although he might have cast it on his soldier if he had it. I'm just going to attack. We'll see what happens. If he has it, it'll be bad. But there's a chance he doesn't have it. Alright, now there's no chance he doesn't have it. Yeah. Oh. Well, okay, that's fine. That's not Test of Faith. That's chump block and gain some life. Or, draw some cards, whatever. That's not a big deal. Still definitely have him on the ropes here. And we can shuffle with Terramorphic Because we've put Shrapnel Blast, Cloud Gut Ranger, and Careful Consideration on the bottom, which are all cards I wouldn't mind drawing at this point in the game. Alright, our guy has been bound. Another Arcbound Worker, sure thing. And probably put Bone Splitter somewhere. Okay. Attack for 3. I think we just take it here. We can always block later. So I'm going to go ahead and crack this to shuffle those cards that I mentioned before back in. But to no avail. So we're drawing to our Cloud Goat Rangers, our Careful Considerations. We got a lot of winners. We're just dead now. Jeez. He played that so quickly, it makes me, like, relatively sure that he just has another one, too. So I block the suited up one, take 4, and then next turn I can block the suited up one again and take 5, so we're just dead no matter what. Well, that was pretty rough. I felt like we got off to a fast start, and he just was able to stabilize a little bit. Alright, I'm going to bring in Dispeller's Capsule for sure. Spellsetter Spray doesn't seem bad either. He had a couple one-drops that are worth countering. For cuts, I think I want to cut Pallid Mycoderm. And I'm not gonna bring in Spellsetter Sprite. It's just too loot. Like countering his one drops is fine and all, but it's not like it's that high impact to counter a one drop. And like, you know, we get a 2-for-1 or whatever, but we countered his one drop. It's not like we did anything that exciting.